guys, what's up? It's Chronic Sinks here. Today we are doing a top 8. Now, most of the time you guys are used to just top 5s, but this time I decided to bump it up by 3, and this is going to be my top 8 favorite YouTubers. Just one disclaimer that all these YouTubers have to be above 100k subscribers, so, yeah. Let's just go through with this, okay. So, coming in at number 8, we have Kavos, or I don't know how I pronounce his name. But what I do know is he's a pretty solid YouTuber. Now this guy, he does rant on YouTubers, but he gives proof of like stuff that they're actually not what they seem to be. Like example, Ruby Rube's parents, not really Ruby Rube herself, but like also, so like Ruby Rube, Sniper Wolf, Derv, those people. You know, this guy, he keeps it to himself, so, yeah. That is why he gets number 8. Well, coming at number 7, we actually have a really popular YouTuber. We have Alyssa Violet. Now, it's not really Alyssa Violet's YouTube channel itself that I congratulate, but it's the video she appears in. You know, her YouTube channel itself was pretty good, but I just think her being in other people's videos can go toward her until, just because, you know, she's a YouTuber, so I think it goes toward her even if it's not exactly on her channel. So the thing I like about her is, you know, she just does kind of standard vlogs. She's not a big person. She does have kind of an arrogant personality, but not in a bad way. Like, it's in a funny way. Like, if someone calls her cute, she's like, I know, but, like, she isn't actually arrogant, but she does joke around being arrogant. Like, it's okay, Alyssa, no hate. I actually appreciate the fact that you do that, because it's funny to watch. Okay. Coming in at number 6, this may be a surprise. I'm not a giant fanboy, but I definitely don't mind these guys. So, coming in at number 6, we have FaZe Apex. Now, I think he's probably, like, easily, like, the second best FaZe member, hands down. He's into gaming, and while being, like, into gaming the way he is, he's also a really good uncle toward his nephew, FaZe Baby. And FaZe Baby has been kind of a help toward his channel. Like, it's been helpful toward his channel, so I think he deserves 6. Now, coming at number 5, this is probably my favorite FaZe member. We have FaZe Banks. Now, after I heard about the FaZe Banks and the Jake Paul controversy, I thought I should check out FaZe Banks to see what was going on. And then, like, I realized that, you know what? He's a pretty good guy. I like how he's not really obsessed with gaming. He's more of a vlogging type of guy and really cares for Alyssa. That, in case you didn't know, that's Alyssa's boyfriend. That's why when I guess someone that way, it might not spoil anything. So, oops. So, you know, FaZe Banks, he's in his unique glow bubble with Alyssa, and he lives with Rice Gum, and, you know, they're happy people together. They have each other's backs, and I think that's always good to see. Coming in at number 4, this will catch you all by surprise. We actually have Poppy. Now, Poppy, it's not really her songs that I would give credit to as much as deciphering her vlogs. Trust me, it's always fun to decipher her vlogs, see what they mean. And the thing about her vlogs, I noticed that sometimes it can end with more than one conclusion, leading to like one giant conclusion, basically. So it's kind of like two paths making one. So, boom. You know what I mean? And Poppy is creepy. There's been a lot of theories going around. I did make a video on her in my channel. I still kind of believe what I said. I'm not going to talk about it, though, just because, you know, this is a happy video. We don't want the sad stuff going on. But, you know what? She's not too bad, so she deserves number 4. Now, coming in number 3, we have the Game Theorist. Now, with the Game Theorist, Now, with this guy having like 8 million or so subscribers, he's just he's big and he's really smart. You know, he has his friends help him out. He started out on his own and kind of grew as it went, kind of how I do. I've talked about in my Evolution of Chronics video how it kind of started. You know, it was just me and then two people came and then just... So you know what I mean. Not much to say about him. He's a super smart guy, very entertaining to watch. Gives crucial points about the stuff he's trying to prove. So we get to number three. Coming in at number two, we actually have the Smith Place. Now, I'm not sure if I mentioned him a couple times on my channel. If I have not, he's easily, like, my favorite zombie player to watch now. He is around 1.7 million subscribers, if I recall. Now, he's really good. Like, he does vlogs sometimes, and, you know, if there's a problem going on, he shares it. You know, he mostly does zombies. Most of his lists are reasonable. Sometimes I do disagree a bit, but probably about 90% of his lists are actually, like, really accurate. So that's why he comes in number two. And before we get to the number one spot, I want to give a few honorable mentions. First honorable mention goes to Relaxing N. Now, this guy is, like, one of the best zombie players out there. Well, not the best, but he's easily probably in, like, the top 15. Top 10. This guy knows what he's doing. He can't really mess up too much. He's got it within him. The only problem I have with him is that he doesn't do commentary or anything like that. No face reveal. Which I like how it's kind of a good twist, but just didn't work out completely in the end. Still funny to watch sometimes, though. And another honorable mention I want to give to Mr. T Luxify. Now, this guy is also another YouTuber. Sometimes I think his sense of humor is a bit too much. Now, trust me, I'd be the first one to tell you that he's probably, like, one of the most funniest YouTubers out there. But, you know, he has his struggles here and there. Sometimes he hates on maps a bit too much, and he is kind of harsh about Transit. I don't consider Transit to be a terrible map. Yes, it's probably the worst, but I'd probably give it a 6 out of 10 at best. So that just goes to show how good the other maps are. And then my last honorable mention has to go to FaZe Jeb. Now with FaZe Jeb, this guy can rage. I mean, he can, like, create a storm the way he rages. And you know what? It's super entertaining to watch. I like it when he just goes with his desk and stuff. He's just like... It's okay, it's just going nice. Yeah, that was just me kind of... Just knocking my drums. Whatever. Let's get to the point. So, yeah. Funny guy. Does rage a bit too much. I don't like how he's evolved into a better person from his old videos, surprisingly. I like it when he's raging all the time. He does rage occasionally, but he's definitely kept it more quiet. Number one. Number one. These two can outstand all the vloggers in the world. At 1.1 million subscribers, the fans supporting them every way they go. These Americans can create a storm with their awesome vlogs and their funny content. Their variety is as good as their performance. I bring you number one, Book of Ken. Now, you guys might sound like, Book of Ken? What is that? A channel where he reads books and you enjoy it? No. This guy, along with his girlfriend Carly, is just beast. Like, these guys have been my favorite YouTube channel for a couple of months now. And the thing I like about these guys, as I said, the variety is just... It's just outstanding the way they did that. And, like, do I have any problems with them? Heck no. You know, they're probably the best... Oh, I saw a spider, but it's just us. Okay. So what I was trying to say is they're probably, like, the best vloggers around. Better than Jake Paul, better than Logan Paul. They can deny it all they want, but I've seen what they can do. And even though they haven't been uploading too much lately because they're moving to L.A., give them the credit they deserve. You subscribe to their channel, you bring them up to 2 million. We celebrate, we scream, they scream. It's ice cream.